First, we're going to write out the equation for the change in internal energy of a thermodynamic cycle. Delta U stands for change in internal energy, Q stands for heat, and W stands for work. Step 1. The very first thing you're going to want to do is solve for the work of the thermodynamic cycle. This will be very easy if you have a graph handy. Simply find the area under the curve of the graph, and you will have calculated the work. Our work is represented here by the red marker. Step 2. Solve for delta U within the formula. The formula we used was 3 over 2 delta PV, standing for pressure and volume, which you will get from the graph. Step 3. Solve for Q using delta U equals Q plus W. Having already found delta U and W, you can rearrange the formula to find Q.
But wait, there's more.
Next, we are going to talk about the differences between refrigerators and heat engines. When looked upon in the context of a graph, the energy flow of a refrigerator goes in a counterclockwise direction. We messed up here. All better. Always remember that it's counterclockwise, but outside of the context of a graph, remember that heat is taken from the system in a refrigerator cycle. A heat engine is the exact opposite, going clockwise. And heat is added to the system rather than removed. Now, we're going to talk about Carnot engines. A Carnot engine could have 100% efficiency if the heat that is created from friction is completely ignored. We couldn't remember the formula for a Carnot engine, so we had to look it up. The formula is TH minus TC over TH times 100, with TH standing for the hottest temperature and TC standing for the coldest temperature. Efficiency can be calculated using a formula that goes P in over P out, P standing for power. 100% efficiency is not possible in the real world.